I'm checking in on May 22, 2009 from a gorgeous place here on the Mediterranean island of Mallorca. I'm here in the town of Sóller with Rafael Forteza, who is the owner of a beautiful country estate and country hotel by the name of Finca Casant. Rafael has been showing me through the property, and we have now reached the orange orchards. Please tell me about the orange plantation here.
Muy bien. La finca Casant tiene aproximadamente 2.5 hectáreas.
Uh-huh. There are 2.5 hectares of orange groves here.
Es una plantación pequeña.
Mm-hmm. It's a small plantation.
Pero dentro de Sóller es una gran plantación porque estamos rodeados de casas. Estamos justo dentro del pueblo.
Mm-hmm. He's saying that actually, despite the fact that this is an agricultural plantation here, we're right in the middle of the village. Or of the town, actually. ¿Cuántos sí. habitantes tiene Sóller?
Ahora debemos estar alrededor de 10.000 habitantes.
So about 10,000 people live in this beautiful mountain town of Sóller, which is also known as the Orange Bowl of Mallorca.
Y por lo general las plantaciones en Sóller no tenían más de 2.000 metros. Eran plantaciones muy, muy pequeñas. Microplantaciones.
Oh, so they are basically micro plantations here in Sóller. Very, very small. 2,000 square meters.
Estas fincas son 18 pequeñas fincas agrupadas a través de 800 años.
Uh-huh. So he's explaining to me that this is actually 18 smaller plantations that were grouped together from 80 years ago when they were sort of put together into one big property.
Pero claro, necesitábamos que las naranjas, que los naranjos fueran productivos.
Uh-huh.
Y hace solo 15 años cambiamos la vieja plantación de estos diferentes trozos y unificamos un poquito todo el criterio.
Ajá, so 15 years ago they started to sort of unify the whole property and also exchange some of the orange trees. Los naranjos se sacaron.
Exactamente.
Ajá, so he exchanged the old orange trees and put in a new, completely new plantation.
Correcto.
Uh-huh.
Ahora ya podemos disfrutarnos y con la producción vendemos la fruta al mercado central. Tenemos para hacer zumo y fruta fresca para los clientes que están en el hotel.
Uh-huh.
Fabricamos una deliciosa mermelada con una factoría, pequeña factoría que también hay en Sóller con personas con handicap.
Uh-huh.
Y también algunos otros productos derivados de la naranja.
Okay, so the oranges are actually, most of them are delivered to the agricultural market here in Sóller, but there is also for the local usage here at the hotel, fresh oranges for consumption, just to eat and to drink as juice, and the finca also produces some orange products that are produced in a local factory that works with disabled people. So they help in the production of orange jam, orange marmalade, and other orange-related products.
Correcto. Y esta, hoy en día, ya esta mermelada ya la exportamos a Europa, a países como Alemania o Inglaterra.
That's incredible. The orange jam that's made here actually is exported to places as far away as Germany and England.
Correcto.
Mm-hmm. And we have a beautiful view here. La vista es maravillosa, ¿no?
La vista es a la mm-hmm. Serra de Tramuntana.
This is the Serra de Tramuntana, the mountain range across northern Mallorca.
Y esta montaña de allí
uh-huh.
es el Puig Mayor.
This is the highest mountain of all of Mallorca, 1,445 meters.
Correcto.
The Puig Mayor.
Correcto.
Mm-hmm. And it has a radar station, military radar. Is that correct?
Correcto. Es un radar mm-hmm. que controla toda la parte occidental del Mediterráneo.
Oh, this radar station up on this mountain actually controls the entire western Mediterranean area.
En el hotel estamos muy seguros y muy tranquilos.
He's saying there's a lot of security and a lot of peace right here in the hotel because we're so nicely protected.
Hoy tenemos una temperatura muy alta para mm-hmm. estar en el mes de mayo.
We have very high temperatures right now at the moment here for the month of May.
Esto es porque hemos tenido vientos del sur.
Oh, we've been having southerly winds.
From Africa.
From Africa, yes.
Y esto produce hace
uh-huh.
es la consecuencia de que el ambiente no esté claro.
Oh, so the atmosphere is hazy. It's not very
Correcto.
Clear.
Mm-hmm. Por normal, cada mm-hmm. día a esta hora,
uh-huh.
las montañas se ven de un color rojo, violeta, rojo. Espectacular.
Oh, really, huh?
Yeah.
He was saying that usually when the air is a little clearer, the mountains surrounding this beautiful property here are purple, red, probably orange, naranjo también. Especialmente con la puesta del sol, ¿no?
Correcto, porque tenemos la puesta del sol detrás y es la tarde es mágica en el Valle del Soya.
I can imagine. The sunset actually is in this direction. This must be west, right? Oeste. Por aquí.
Eso.
¿Dónde?
Justo, ahí tenemos
justo.
El sol.
Ah, aquí es el sol. So that's where the sun is. So the sun shines over here in the afternoon. And the mountains are painted all sorts of colors, so it becomes a magical environment.
Y esta es una habitación del hotel.
So this is also a guest room of the hotel.
Todas las habitaciones son independientes.
All the guest rooms are completely independent. They have their own bathrooms.
Y es como si estuvieran en una pequeña casita.
This is like being in a little casita in a small little independent country house.
Correcto.
Perfect. What a view.
Gracias.
Here. Yeah, thank you so much for your time. This is beautiful. And you were telling me about the oranges. Las naranjas maduran durante los meses de enero y febrero.
Correcto. Las naranjas es increíble.
Ajá.
Hay más de 40,000 variedades de naranjas.
There are more than 4,000 varieties of oranges. Here, aquí.
No. En el mundo. La naranja
in the world.
Tiene mucha facilidad para mutar.
Ah, so oranges are very prone to mutations.
Correcto. De estas 40,000, solo 40 son comerciales.
So only 40 out of 4,000 different varieties of oranges are actually commercialized.
Cuando hicimos la nueva plantación, tuvimos que elegir una de estas 40.
So he had to select one specific variety when they were making the new plantation.
Y buscamos una cuya maduración fuera entre febrero y mayo.
Oh, okay. So they were actually looking for a specific variety that would bear fruit in January and February.
Porque por la noche la temperatura es inferior a 18 grados centígrados.
So at night the temperature is below 18 degrees Celsius.
Y esto significa que muchos insectos no pueden prosperar.
Ah, so that means that most insects actually can't survive those temperatures, so there's less insect infestation.
Y podemos hacer una producción casi 100% ecológica.
And the result of that, choosing this particular variety, means that the oranges are almost completely organic. So you don't have to use a lot of pesticide or herbicide.
Correcto. Solo excepcionalmente cuando el naranjo lo necesita para proteger la vida del propio árbol.
This is rather exceptional because usually oranges need a lot of help to prosper because they are very susceptible to insects.
Correcto.
So this was a perfect choice.
Correcto.
Thank you so much, Rafael, for
Gracias.
This educating interview. And we will continue on. Thank you.
Gracias.